Just like many of the classic film noirs, Stanley Kubrick's 1956 film The Killing strategically employs lighting as a cinematic tool for expression. However, I'd like to stress the word strategically, as according to Patrick Keating, many film noirs such as The Killing turn out to be surprisingly classical in terms of overall style. He continues, stating that the lighting is expressive, but the expressivity is expertly balanced with other goals, like glamour or realism. This is important in our understanding of The Killing, as the lighting throughout the film is motivated by a unique blend of these sometimes conflicting motivations. A sequence that exemplifies the complex lighting of this film is the scene in which Sherry visits Val at his apartment. This scene stands out in particular because it features three distinct moments of strategic lighting that carefully reflect the shifts that occur in their conversation. This first shot is especially notable for its use of gendered lighting, which favors low-key expressive lighting for the male star and high-key lighting for the female. Instantly noticeable is the low-key lighting used on Val, as the entire left side of his face is casted in shadow. Using this effect, Kubrick is able to quickly paint Val as a morally ambiguous character, and possibly even foreshadow his villainous turn later in the film. Notice by contrast, when Sherry turns to the camera, her face is evenly lit. This allows her, in Keating's words, to become the site of uninhibited emotional expression. Unlike Val, emotion is conveyed through her facial expressions rather than through the lighting choices. This choice to light for glamour here is especially interesting, considering Sherry is very much the femme fatale of this film. However, as Sherry begins to discuss leaving George, the lighting instantly reflects the shifting mood. As she gets up to leave the frame, her face becomes obscured in shadow, and this darker lighting style continues as they move over to the fireplace. Whereas Val was the focus in the previous shot, the focus here has clearly shifted to Sherry. This is reinforced by the staging and the much more expressive lighting seen on Sherry's face. The two then move again to provide what is easily the most striking moment of lighting in this whole scene. The lamp scene near the bottom of the frame is the main motivation for the expressive lighting in this setup. The resulting underlighting provides a unique blend of harsh light and shadow on both of their faces. The conversation has reached a peak intensity during this moment, and the ominous high contrast lighting reinforces this escalation. Lighting is an aspect of film form that I think is just unfortunately often taken for granted. However, scenes such as this one show that very careful thought is put into the lighting of films, and the decisions the director and cinematographer make are influenced by a variety of industrial and creative factors.